how can we compute the inverse of a matrix? Well, let us start with elementary matrices. The inverse of an elementary matrix is easy, and even better, the elementary matrices will teach us how to find the inverse of a matrix in general, as you will learn in this video. So, what's the inverse of an elementary matrix? Let us start with our first step, E1. You get that by interchanging two rows of the identity matrix. Well, for the inverse, you need to interchange them back, basically. And how can you do that? Well, by multiplying with the same elementary matrix on the left, because this E1 inverse does exactly the same operation. So if you multiply with it on the left, it interchanges back the rows of A, so E1 inverse times E1 gives you the identity matrix again. So, actually in this case, E1 and E1 inverse are the same matrix. Something similar holds for E2. So, what does E2 do? It multiplies row by a factor of 2. How do you undo that operation? Well, by multiplying the same row by a factor 1/2, and that's how you get E2 inverse. Something similar for E3. So, what does E3 do? In this case, you add minus to the first row to the last row. How do you undo that operation? Well, by adding again, but now 2 times the first row to the last row. Because first you add minus 2 times the first row to the last row, and then you would add 2 times the first row to the last row, so that those operations cancel out, and the product will give you the identity matrix. So you see, in all three cases, the inverse of an elementary matrix is again an elementary matrix, which looks very similar. Now, what happens? How can you apply this in general? What happens if you have A and N times N matrix, which you can row reduce to the identity matrix? So, you know from the invertible matrix theorem, if you can row reduce A to the identity matrix, then A is invertible, and if you can't row reduce A to the identity matrix, then A is not invertible. So let's assume A is invertible, and you can row reduce it, so you can row reduce it to the identity matrix. Then you know you have a sequence of row operations which do the job. So you have a sequence of E1 to EK, such that if you apply them to your matrix A, that you get the identity matrix. But now you can read off what the inverse of A is, because here you have some matrix, the product of EK to L1 times A is the identity matrix, so that means that your A inverse is exactly EK up to E1. So there you have a formula for your A inverse. And furthermore, you know if you invert this expression that your A should be E1 inverse, E2 inverse up to EK inverse. Well, let's try to check this. Here we have our matrix A, same from a previous example. Well, you have, because this is 2 by 2, you have an explicit formula for the inverse, but let's check that one. So the inverse of A is 1 over the determinant. The determinant of A equals 6 minus 3 equals 3, so 1 over 3. And then you interchange the 2 and the 3, and you put minuses for the 1 and the 3. So you have an explicit formula for your A inverse. But what happens if you try to use elementary matrices? Well, we know from a previous example what elementary matrices to use. Here we have our 4 elementary matrices. Here we have our matrix A. And together they gave the identity matrix. So that means that our A inverse is the product of those 4 matrices. So let's compute that product. So the product over here. In the first step, we just copy these 2 matrices. And with the first multiplication, we get 1, 0, and then a 1 and a minus 1 over 3. Then in the next step, we leave the last matrix over here. And we compute this product over here. So we get 1 minus 2 equals minus 1. minus 1/3 times minus 2 equals 2/3. 1 plus 1 equals 1. And 0 plus minus 1 over 3 yields 1 over 3, minus 1 over 3. And finally, we compute the last product. We get a 1 minus 1 over 3, a minus 1, and a 2 over 3. A and we have our aim verse. And as you can see, it's indeed the same as this one. So, how can you find your aim verse? Well, you figure out the correct elementary matrices from the row reduction of A, put them in the right order, take the product, and there you have your aim verse. And now, of course, for a 2x2 matrix, this is a lot of work and you have a direct formula. So for a 2x2 matrix, you're never going to use this. However, for bigger matrices, like 3x3, 4x4, the formula for an inverse can be quite complicated. So for bigger matrices, actually, this idea will give us the algorithm to find the inverse of a matrix, as you will learn in a later video.